Hi everyone, in this video, we are going to talk about how to combine different data tables together. As you may know, in real life, you are going to record data from different resources. And it is very rare that you can do the analysis with one single data table. So, very frequently, you may need to combine different information from different data sources and then use the full information for data analysis. So that's what we are going to script. And then we are going to load a few packages first. The first package is called tidyverse, because this is a very useful collection of packages. It includes deployer, which is for data manipulation, and it also includes ggplot2, which is great at data visualization. And it also has another package called table, which is for generating tables, which we are going to use today. So if you have never installed tidyverse, you may want to type install.packages tidyverse. So you need to run that line to install that package and then run the second line to load the package. Another package I want you to install or load is called NYC Flights 13. So this package includes a few datasets that we are going to talk about today. And if you have never installed that package, you want to type install.packages NYC Flights 13 within the quotation mark. So run that line and then run this line to load the package. So the datasets we are going to look at are flights, which includes the flights information in the year of 2013. It has departure time, departure delay, arrival time, arrival delay, and carrier information, flight information, tail number, origin, destination, and so on. Another dataset is called airlines. It has the airline code, the carrier, and the name. And then a third dataset is called planes. So if you run that line, you're going to see like the specific information of the different tail number of the airplanes. So we have year, type, manufacturer, model, and so on. Another dataset is called weather, which is showing the weather on a specific day at different airports. There's another dataset called airports. So you can see the airports are actually the airport code, the full name, the latitude, longitude, and all those information. If you want to see more explanations of these datasets, you can just use a question mark of those datasets name so that you can have detailed explanation of each variables. So you can see, you can just run those things and all the explanations will be there. And think they are just related to each other. And these datasets are actually called relational data because they are related to each other and their relations are very important for us to combine them and then to analyze them. And then let's talk about a function, a series of functions about drawings. It has left drawing, right drawing, full drawing, and inner drawing. So before we talk about all these drawing functions, let's focus on left drawing first. So once you know how to use left join, you are able to use the other three join functions in the same sense. So suppose my first question here is that I want to add the airline information to my flights dataset. So suppose my major focus is the flights, all the information about the flights. But I also want to have the airline information because the airline provides the carrier code. Like we only have two letters as the carrier, and which is also available in the flights dataset. We want to have the full name of the carriers. Then what we can do is to use flights and left join, and then we type airlines, and the by variable will be set up as carrier. So this here is our key variable. So this variable is used as the key to match the values of airlines to flights, and the new variable name will be added to the flights dataset. So I run this, and if I check the variables of the flights, or if I check the data of the flights, you can see my dataset has 19 total columns ending with time hour. And if I view, so maybe I update this data as flights airline and run that so that my flights airline is defined. And then I can view this newly created dataset. It now has 20 columns, and the newest column is called name, which is the name, the full name of airlines added to the flights dataset. So my second example here is that I want to check or add the weather information to flights dataset. So to do that, I want to check what variables are there in the flights, in the weather dataset, and what variables are there in the flights dataset, like what common variables they have. Think about a weather. So you can see we have a region, year, month, day, hour. Those variables are all in flights data. We also have time, hour variable. And also our variable is here. So you can see there are a lot of common variables of these two data sets. What we can do is to use left join and then type weather. I don't need to specify the by variable. And by has a default value, which is the common variables. So which means if you don't specify any key, then the data set will be matched using all the common variables they have. So you can see after the time hour, we are adding temperature and so on. All those variables are from weather and they are matched to the flights. So you can even define this variable as this new data set as flights weather, which means you now have flights and weather information together all in this data set. And my third example here, let's see, we have flights. Maybe we can add the plane information, the airplane information. So add the airplane information to the flights data, right? So I don't need to run a note, but I want to check what data I have, what variables I have in these two data sets out there. So I want to run the variable names. Sorry, I had a typo. So the planes data is not airplanes. So I have the variable year here. I also have a variable year here. But that year is the year that the planes are made. So we cannot match this year with this year because they are not talking about the same thing. But there is a variable I noticed, it is called tail number, which is also listed here. So this time we cannot let the two data sets combined by default because we don't want the year to be wrong, incorrectly matched. So we want to match by tail number. By doing that, we can let flights left join and then planes by equals tail number. So we are matching the two data set with their tail number. And you can see the new data set has those variables added. The new year, the year that is manufactured, type, manufacturer, engines, sys, speed, and engine. Those new information is from the planes dataset, and they are now added to the flights dataset. So now you know if you want to combine airplanes, airlines, weather, and the planes, all those information from different sources to the flights data, you can actually do that. Like you can use the flights airline and then left join weather. Then you have three sources of information. And then you can use flights airline weather combined with planes. Then you have four sources of information. So that's how you combine all sorts of different data tables together into a full data set. Okay, I believe you get the idea of left join. And I want to draw a quick picture showing you how we are doing the left join. So for left join, suppose I have two data tables here. And suppose this is the key variable, and this is X, and this is the key variable, like they're used to be matched. And that's why. So left join is like if I have 1 and 2 here, and this is A and B, my second data set, I only have 1 and 3. Or maybe 2. Suppose I have both 1, 2, and then 3, and this is C, D, E. Left join means that this table will be used to find 1 and 2. If they have 1, that value Y will be added here, and that C will be put here. If I have 2, 2 can be found in table 2, then that Y value E will be added to the first data table. Because I don't have 3 in this first data table, so that information will not be used. So the final output of the data is like this. So that is called left join, according to the left side of the data table. And then I'm going to show you some example data like what I draw here so that you can see them clearly about right drawing, inner drawing, full drawing. First of all, I'm going to create tables. So I let X equals tables. And my key variable are 1, 2, 3, and then my variable X are AA, UA, and then DA. I'm just making up things according to the airline information. And then my variable Y, dataset Y, has 1, 2, and 4. And my variable y has the values of American Airline, comma, United Airline, and then maybe JetBlue table. So if I do left drawn of x and y, then they will be matched using the key, right? I haven't run this tool. So now I'm going to run the two tables here, and then I'm going to run left drawn. So you can see my tables are joined by key. And because 3 is not found in table Y, so that is NA. I can also do right drawn XY. So you can see when I do right drawn, my second data set is used as the base. And then any value that can be matched will be added here, and there is no 4, so this is an A. I can also do inner drawn X and Y, and the result will be only 2, 1 and 2. Inner drawn means only those can be matched will be paired and created a data set. So you can see that's the smallest data set you can get. And full drawn is just the opposite. Anything that can be found in X or in Y will be listed, and anything that is not matched will be listed as an A. So that's it. I hope you get the idea of the joining functions. And I hope you enjoyed my video. Thank you.